Hey guys, Ketan again. So the problem that we are solving today is from the beginner level of CodeChef, and it is smallest numbers of nodes, right? We completed till chef and operators. So yeah, the problem code is FLOW005. The problem statement is, consider a currency system in which there are nodes of 7 denominations, namely rupee 1, rupee 2, rupee 5, rupee 10, rupee 50 and 100, right? If sum of rupees n is input, write a program to compute smallest number of nodes that will combine to give n. Right guys, so when we have an amount to pay, we have to find minimum number of nodes that we have to give to the another person using these denominations, right? So if we have 100, we can give it in multiple ways. So we can use 250s or 100 or 10 tens or 25s or 52s or 101s. So this is very stupid. So we have to we want to use minimum number of nodes, right? So that's the problem. Well, it could be solved in two ways. We could use dynamic programming, but I don't think that's necessary for this. That will be an overkill. So I'll be using a simple method over here. So we got test cases and the the amount which you have to, let's call it amount, right? What we'll do is we'll create a list L. Okay, we'll call it denom. This is for denominations, and that we'll put the denominations in reverse order, right? So 100, and then we got 50, and then we got what, 10, 5, 2, and 1. This is it, I think. Yeah, so we'll be putting these things in the reverse order. So, and now what we'll do is, while amount not equal to 0, what we're doing here is we are getting the multiple with which we are dividing amount with the denom, right? And then we're doing that, we are decrementing the amount so that all the higher values, all the possible hundreds are given away, and then we are incrementing the answer for that, which will be the multiple. And then we are incrementing I, which means the denomination is decreased. So what we are doing is, first of all, we are giving all the possible hundreds that we can give, and then we are giving away all the possible 50s that we can give, and so on and so forth. So what happens is, when we are going in each iteration, we are decreasing the highest denomination that we are using, right? So when all of it is done, we can just print the answer. This should work. Let's see. Oh, sorry. So yeah, Python doesn't accept that. Let's code up and see. So we got 12, 5, and 7, which are right. So let's submit this and see. Should work. There we go. Right guys, so what is the time complexity of this? Well, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Well, the maximum time complexity will be, so if there are m denomination, the time complexity will be O of m, right? Because we are going through each denomination once, right? So it's not actually dependent on n, it's actually dependent on number of denominations are present, right? Okay guys, so if you like the video, like hit the like button, and if you want to subscribe for more content, do it. And if you find this interesting, or this channel interesting, and if your friend is also interested in programming, then you can share the video. Thanks guys.